ever render a bright interior and it turns out into a flat washout mess? I struggled with these issues many times in the past until I found a perfect solution. Today, I'll show you how to quickly lighten up the interior space with daylight. Here, I've got a living room scene made entirely with Chaos Cosmos assets. So if you want, you can easily recreate it. I just quickly changed some materials or adjusted them. It's a simple setup. One room, two windows, and the camera pointed straight at the sofa. Super common angle. The thing that can get a bit tricky is the window behind the camera. But we'll make it work. Let's start in render settings. We're using V-Ray today, so make sure V-Ray is checked. I'll also lock the camera so we don't accidentally mess up the view. Next up, material override. When I'm working on lighting, I like to start with a white model first, because materials can get confusing really fast at the beginning. So I'll pick a standard V-Ray material and use it as the override. Now I'll use the include-exclude list to exclude the windows from the override. Cool, now we can move on to lighting. I'll create a V-Ray sun and place it in the viewport. And yes, I'll let it automatically add V-Ray sky to the environment. Otherwise, you'd have to do it manually. Press 8 to open the environment settings. Alright, let's start interactive rendering. And yep, it's super dark. So first, I'll add light mix. Go to render setup and add V-Ray light mix as a render element. Then start interactive rendering again. The light layers were added automatically here. Now we just need exposure. I'll go into the camera settings and turn on auto exposure. Perfect. Next, I'll turn off the interior lights for now. I want to set up the environment lighting first. I'm going for a clean daylight look with a bit of sun coming in and creating a nice pattern on the wall. I'll move the sun up. These old style windows give a really cool shadow pattern. I'll hide the curtains for the moment, and I'll move the sun even higher, because I want more of a late morning vibe, not sunrise. Then I'll adjust the sun position until the pattern on the wall looks right. I want it less stretched. I'll show you the light separately. Just the sun now. And here is what the environment light looks like. I like to keep the environment on one to get a natural look. Let's do a quick basic post-production. I need to tweak exposure. I really like the new exposure layer because it feels more like photo editing. You get way more control. I'll make it brighter but also add some contrast. I forgot to turn on the sun. Let's turn it on now. I'll definitely lower the highlights to avoid blowing things out, making the image too washed out and overexposed. I'll reduce whites too. Slightly more contrast. And I'll lift the shadows a bit. I'll reduce the highlights even more. The sun still feels a bit too strong. We could just lower the intensity, but I prefer adding clouds first to soften the lighting naturally. So in the V-Ray sun settings, I'll turn on clouds and play with the density. If I go lower, the sun will be more prominent, but I want it less intense. If I push it over 0.5, the sun pattern basically disappears, so I'll keep the default. I like it, but I still want a bit less sun, so I'll reduce the sun intensity to 0.7. Nice. Back to post. I'll adjust white balance, maybe slightly toward warm colors. I also like adding the filmic tone map layer, because it gently tones everything down. In this case, though, I'll bring back a bit of highlights using the exposure layer. And right at the end, I'll add curves to push the contrast a little more. Looks good. Now I can add the lamp models to the exclusion list and start interactive rendering again. Nice. But to keep the balance, we need to lower the lamp intensity. Cutting it by half looks good. This one can stay a bit stronger. Now I'll unhide the curtain and add it to the exclusion just to show you why it's worth having it in the scene. We need to start rendering again. Look at the wall. It creates a really nice soft shadow. Those little details actually matter. Okay. Now I'll turn off the material override so we can see it with the real materials. This time, I'll use standard rendering to see more details. Let it render a bit longer. And yeah, it's very bright and kind of washed out. Not great. Like I said at the start, that light coming from behind the camera can be a problem. So here's a simple trick. We block it. Since it's not visible in the camera, we can just add a simple box there, instead of something like a thick curtain. No need to overthink it because you won't see it anyway. We just need to cover the window area. I'll assign a standard viewing material to the box. I'll use the history panel to show you what changed. It's pretty handy to use in situations like those. You'll see the difference immediately. We don't even need a long render. I'll save the second version and I'll show you an A-B image comparison. Now the room has way more depth and contrast, and the light feels under control. Look at this side table, it looks so much better. We can still improve it a bit though. It's a little dark now. I'll add some exposure back. I'll also use a darker color on the blocker to really emphasize contrast and keep the shadows deeper. Let's render again and see the final result. You can see how much control we get here. A darker box means darker shadows. A brighter box means brighter shadows. And at the very end, I'll add lens effects to get a nice subtle bloom coming from the window. I'll adjust the basic parameters, size and intensity. And that's it. Ready to render. It's a simple daylight interior technique, but it works really well, especially in bright interiors where everything tends to lose contrast and go washed out. Let me know if you tried by yourself and how it went. And don't forget to subscribe for more tips like that. Bye-bye!